Hey there, my name is Ming. It's Friday, welcome to Chinese Star Galactica. The topic for this week is looking back, looking forward. What is your favorite TSG video? And for my video, I'm going to talk about Angela. She had a video a while ago called Minority Report, where she talks about the support or lack thereof she receives from other minority groups. And in this video, she sort of branches out a little bit and talks about the oppressions she's experienced as a black person and compares it to the oppressions that she experiences as a queer person and as a trans person. From her experience, the racial oppression was almost worse. And I would like to pick up on that because I thought that was a really nuanced way of looking at it. So in this video, I throw out some theories out there on why the racism she experienced could almost be seen as worse as transphobia or homophobia. So the USA and its younger brother Canada, to a lesser extent, was built on the expropriation of land, lives, and labor. The American Indians and black people of the land, their lives were the cost of the building of this nation. So when we talk about racism today, what often gets lost is that history, that material history of the expropriation of their labor for the cause of capitalism. So we're talking about slavery. We're talking about the stealing of indigenous land. Well, why did those things happen? Is it because certain people were mean? No, it is because labor and land means surplus, and surplus is the logic of capitalism. So what we today refer to as racism actually has its roots in capitalism. Today, there is a vogue. There's a type of theory that is really in vogue, and it's called intersectionality analysis. One of the things that intersectionality theory really fails to analyze is it has forgotten about the historical material background of all oppressions. So unless intersectionality theory can start taking these material conditions of oppression into account again, intersectionality theory remains crude. And to apply historical materialism to trans politics, let's compare the trans movement, transphobia, to racism. Trans is obviously different from race. Transphobia is different from racism. First of all, trans is a relatively young phenomenon. It has not really seen a political movement rise. It has not really seen a political movement that tried to liberate the lives of trans people. And it's also distinguishable from racial oppression and colonialism in that trans affects people during different times in their lives, unlike colonialism and racism, which doesn't make a distinction between that. And for some people, trans is a temporary phenomenon, whereas for others, it's a lifelong process. But for the most part, for racialized people, like black people and Indian people, it is not a temporary phenomenon. You cannot detransition from being black or being Indian. And it certainly doesn't end. So, in terms of relationship to capitalism, trans is probably most distinguishable in that transphobia, also known as the enforcement of the social division of labor, means that trans people's main oppression under capitalism is that we are excluded from it, which sounds absurd, right? Like, how can exclusion from capitalism be a bad thing? Well, it is when we live in a world where the majority of people must sell their labor in order to make a wage, in order to survive. So, to reiterate, the most distinguishable feature about transphobia is probably labor market exclusion. And this differs, obviously, from racial and colonial oppression, because racial and colonial oppression were based on, they were not based on excluding from Indian people and Black people from capitalism. In fact, Indian people and Black people were part and parcel of what made capitalism function. So without the land and without labor, capitalism would not be what it is today. And for trans people, the contradiction is that we have yet to really start being incorporated into capitalism, although it is happening in certain countries. So we are really at a divergent point in terms of our own movements, where we can push to be included in capitalism, or we can push for something farther. So I think that's a topic for another day, but just for the purpose of today, basically the point to take home is that because intersectionality theory often fails to recognize the historical materialist roots of oppressions, it has very strong political implications. And what are those? Well, according to intersectionality, we should combat all oppressions. We should combat racism, we should combat sexism, we should combat ableism, transphobia, fatphobia, anti-sex work, and the list grows daily. Well, I agree we should combat those things. But when we sort of listen to what intersectionality theory has to say about oppressions, which often forgets about the historical materialist roots of oppression, we get stuck in battling only ideologies or representations. So often we'll be outraged by what's happening in the media. We'll be outraged by negative portrayals of trans people. We'll be frustrated at some really asinine commenter or columnist on the National Post or your favorite American reactionary newspaper. We'll be outraged by those things. And we're right to be outraged. Those things are important. Ideologies, reactionary ideologies, are very telling of the society we live in. However, it is not the cause. Negative representations are very telling of how the system is not working, but it is not the cause. Unless we start focusing on the material conditions for trans oppression and for racial oppression, colonialism, gender oppression, we are stuck at battling representations and ideologies, which is exhausting at best, and at worst, a form of activist inaction. So the point to take home, once again, is to challenge and change the material conditions rather than simply the ideologies and representations. If we trans people were to actively change our own lives and fight for the liberation of trans people, as well as all oppressed peoples around us. So I think I've talked for long enough. Thank you for listening. Please let me know what you think. I put a lot of thought into this, and I'm not sure if it's any good. So I would appreciate words of encouragement or constructive criticism. Thanks.